The pandemic has been hard on all of us, some more than others.
We're really noticing that there's a lot of people without opportunities when the pandemic hit.
Tony Sane, CEO of the Sane Foundation, says kids especially have had their lives turned upside down, moving into a strange new world of online learning. But not every student has the same access to that new world. Hearing countless stories of struggling students, Sane decided to step in, turning the Sane Foundation Gymnasium into a free learning center.
I'm very happy to have it here.
Shamar Williams sends her two sons here 5 days a week. From 8 to 2, they set up their computers and learn. And from 2 to 6, they get a safe place to play until their mom gets off of work.
They're getting good grades and they getting better in school.
A very good program for her to come every day.
Nia Robinson says it's not just the free internet and technology that's helping her 8-year-old daughter. The center also has tutors who float around and make sure the students don't fall behind.
Here she has the one-on-one attention where she can learn and get her schoolwork done without any interference.
There are about a dozen other centers just like this across the Twin Cities, with 10 more on the way. It's all part of a new program through Comcast. The company provides free internet and the tools community groups need to get started. Here at the Phyllis Wheatley Community Center in Minneapolis, they're hoping to get this lift zone up and running by November 21st.
We believe this is an area that we should be focusing in on because the gap is so great.
Here they'll focus exclusively on Black teenage boys, who will learn life skills and career readiness as part of a 12-week program.
And that ultimately that they see that there are caring adults for them, that they really do care about their continued learning.
Thanks to Comcast, centers will have free internet for the next 3 years to help close the digital divide and give more students more opportunities, even after the pandemic is over.
And make sure that every child has, you know, food to eat, a safe place to go, and educational support so that they can get what they deserve, so they can thrive.
Gordon Severson, Care 11 News.